Hi guys, it's Ernest. Welcome to my tuning video. And this topic, we're going to cover creep. Oh, what is that? Well, I'm talking about regulated creep. On the Delrin piston, on most FX air guns, I'm going to cover why it would leak, how to fix it. All right, let's get to it. All right, first things first, we need to confirm if the gauge is working properly. Now let me go through how the gauge work. All right, it's called a bottom gauge, and it senses pressure through here, and it goes up, and it goes through three coils, then they're copper, and when pressure goes through this, it wants to expand. All right, there's a little micro little hole in it, a passage to this coil, so when you pressurize it, it expands. Want to expand out, so at the end of it there's a little wire attached to it, so that wire wants to expand that way because it's attached to the coil here where the pressure's at. So when it expands out, see, it wants the needle moves, all right, and it shows you what pressure it is, all right, in relation to the movement of this wire, and this tubing wants to expand. It's calibrated in a way, it'll read pretty close to whatever it says in bars, right? There's a tolerance here, 5 or 10% accuracy-wise, depends on the gauge. So, not all gauges are created equal, and you have to troubleshoot the gauge before you go into the regulator. Alright, now we're going to test out your original gauge, alright? So let's assume there's pressure here, or you just pressurize it. You want to do is tap on a gauge. It's a habit of mine because it's mechanical. Sometimes it moves, and there's a lot of times I've seen this gauge move when I tap on it. All right, that's not good. So to confirm if this working is tracking, the gauge is tracking good. So we want to test that. I usually put a tape on the left hand side, a needle. I can see it there. All right. Because you don't want it on the right hand side, because you want to see the needle and rise up, not behind it. All right. So, and it's a waiting game. Right? You wait and wait till it creeps up. When it creeps up, you need to crony the gun. If there's 15, 20 bars higher, guarantee you your speed will drop. You know, 15, maybe, or around there. So you want to confirm that, and you don't do it just once. You do it twice, all right, to confirm your speed is lower, and you do suspect there is a creep, but. I always don't rely on the original gauge. I always get another one. Because I have a reference gauge. I know it's good. I mark it. And I swap it and do the same test. Alright. If both gauges indicating an increase of 15 or 20 bars or whatever. And the speed is low. Now we determine it is a regulator creep. All right, then we'll go through that next. All right, here is your regulator Delrin piston. And here's your regulator adjustment screw. All right, let me go through the path of the high pressure air. So you kind of a little bit understand if you've never seen how the air flows through the impact. All right. Your main source is your bottle. So the pressure goes through here. And this action is bored out. A little hole all the way through here. All the way through. All right, when they bore this out, they put a little plug down here, all right, to seal it, both ends here and behind, and little brass piece right there. That's all there is. They're plugs when they milled the passage for the high pressure air, all right. When it's inside here, all right, the high pressure air goes through this little hole here, all right, inside this regulator body. Now, what's inside here is your regulator adjustment screw. Now, there's a little teeny hole here. I could zoom in, focus it, because I get that. All right, let me put it inside. There's a hole here. I haven't measured it, but that thing's like 0.10 mil. It's small, all right. And it, after it goes through there and it goes up, because it's nothing down here, it's plugged. It's not plugged, but it's not milled through. And this really dead center, I don't know if you can see it. I know you're looking at my dirty hands, but I'm a working hand. Anyway, right there is so small, right? So it comes out, the pressure comes out there. It's not reduced yet, all right? So this regulator adjustment screw is inside here and it's sealed, right? And there's another O-ring inside here that seals this regulator piston when it goes inside here, all right, to prevent it from leaking. And inside here, these two are like this, mated together, all right. So the regulator side and after the piston side, the plenum, are two separate chambers, all right. What separate them is your spring washers. Alright, so it's open to the atmosphere side. So there's no way in any size or form air will go in your plenum unless it goes through this little teeny hole here. Right there, it's so small. It's right beside the center where it plugs the supply in. It just plugs it and prevent it from air from entering the plenum side. All right, it's so small. It's about the same size as the one in the adjustment screw here. It's small. It goes through right there off center, then it goes in the middle and comes out of here. All right, then after it comes out of here, it goes through this chamber. All right. But this chamber is sealed because the plenum tube that goes in here and gets clamped. All right. So it goes to the plenum tube and fills the plenum. So there's no way to fill the plenum unless it's creeping through this. All right. The only way it'll creep through there is micro imperfection of the plastic or Delrin. In here, you sometimes you can't even see it. It's so small you can't see it. All right, sometimes it's man-made force. Some owners don't know which way to turn this, and they jammed it in there really tight, and it makes a little indent in there. All right, even though it's kind of dome, it still creates a damage in it. And when it compresses really tight, it causes a little gouges in it. All right, and sometime you have foreign matters that get into the gun, even metal pieces, they could even get embedded through here because that passage is a restrictor flow right there. Anything bigger than that is going to jam that hole, and it's going to slow down, or you know, the refresh rate is going to affect the plenum because it's partially plugged here or in here. Alright, usually I get a wire brush, they're about perfect size. I just go through there and clear the holes, the passage. One through here and out here. Sometimes I put LP air and blow it out and try to feel air coming out the other side. That's to make sure your passages are clean. All right. So the next step is to polish the Delrin and have a little slight dome to it. I mean, very slight. And the rig adjustment screw has a slight dome on it, but we're going to polish it to make it rid of those little micro little rivers down there. And so it gives a way of the air to bypass and go inside this piston and fill your plenum. And that's kind of system you're experiencing, the rig creep. All right, we'll do that next. All right, this one area I forgot to cover. I'd like to go through it before we start, you know, working on the rig piston. It's how does it shut the pressure? All right. Just assuming your spring washers are here. All right, the spring washers pushes the piston out. Let's see, I'll get my camera here. You know, it doesn't, if it prevents it from touching, it wants to spring out and forces this piston open. I'm over exaggerating here. They don't open that big. It's just like, I don't know, 0.15 the max it will open up. All right, with no pressure in the gun, this is open because the spring is forcing it open. All right, now when air is applied to the gun, it'll go through all this little passage and go through here and fills your plenum. Now, when your plenum reaches a certain pressure, whatever stack you had, whatever tension's on it, is going to force this piston to touch the brass piston, in terms plugging the hole or stop it from coming out, cutting the valve supply, right? Cut the river, whatever it is stopping the flow. Alright. So we want to polish both ends so minimize creeping in between the two. Alright, we'll do that next. Alright. What we're going to need for this procedure is a 3M fiber cloth, microfiber cloth. It's like cloth, but we're going to work in a sequence of grits. I usually graze around, I think it's 800 grit. Then it's kind of the blue is 1200. Pink, it's about 3,000, and it's about, I think, 6,000, 5,000. I know where it's very, very fine. All right, so what we're gonna do, we'll start with six. We're gonna start with the Delrin piston. As you notice, let me zoom in. Let's see it. You see the surface, original surface. All right, now we're gonna do a put this stuff out of the way. Now, you want to go on circular motion. Concentrate on the other edge, so you'll create some kind of really shallow dome. Now, you want to do this, you go like this, and flip it out a little bit. And then go around in circle again. Now this doesn't remove a lot of material, it just barely. Now we go back and look at it. See it? It's no longer shiny. And concentrate on the middle, that's where it counts the most. Make sure it's sanded in that area too. All equal surface. Alright. Now we go to the next grit. Usually blue, not turquoise. Blue. We don't want to put this on a lathe because heat, it will take out too much. If you do it manually, you have a lot of control how much polishing is done. You have more control. All right, look at it again, verify. You hit all corners. If you don't hit the middle, it's a little duller, and the outside a little more polished. So I want to hit the middle more. You see there, it's kind of starting to polish all throughout. All right, your next one. And look at it, you can see it, so polished up. Make sure the center is polished right there. Now go to the final grit. I'm not putting a lot of pressure on this, guys. It's, you know. So it looks like this when it's polished evenly. Alright. See how polished it is? Now, you gotta do the same thing on the drag adjustment screw. Alright, with the rest. On this one, we want to concentrate in the middle because it's only partially domed. Right. That's how it looks with this grit. And a little blue. Yeah. Let's get in there. Let me get a little closer like that. Oops. Now see how pink does. How shiny it is. Yeah. Final. Here's your final polish. See, it's like a mirror. Alright, when it's done with this, you need to blow air. It's all the standing. Sometimes it gets to the pores or the bore. Usually get your wire brush again in there or blow it air. And your piston here. See the way they look now, then before. I wish I had before and after we started each other, but it looks really nice. So I doubt it. All right, have a perfect seal now. All right, so we're gonna assemble this and test it. But let me tell you what not to do. You don't go overboard, go crazy, and take a lot of material off this piston here, this Delrin, because you don't want to take too much out. I mean, I barely took out anything out of this. So inside the reg body, there's an O-ring in here, all right, and it has to go through past the O-ring and creates a seal. Now, if you removed a lot of material off of this, this piston is not going to seal right, because there's a certain amount of washers and stacking here. So when air got compressed, this piston doesn't, there's a limit how far it goes in. If you limit how much it goes in, it doesn't touch that O-ring in here and creates a seal, it'll leak down your vent hole. All right, so do not remove any more than, I mean, that's that, not even a hair. I mean, it's like, if there was a millimeter, it's 0.001 mil. It's very, very slight material I removed just to polish it. All right. All right, let me cover this one area, and most people don't quite understand. All right. Why they have certain creep issue. It's not related on a surface, it's not related to the, you know, imperfection of these two surfaces not mating. It's the, let's say, these washers, spring washers, is forcing this piston open, and the plenum is also trying to fight the piston, right, to shut it, right. If you have too much the spring stack in relationship to the plenum, right, if they're not balanced, it will affect how much pressure needed to shut the valve, what you call it, shut the supply. It's like a faucet, you know, old faucet back in the days. You just barely, you know, close it. It doesn't shut all the way. You feel a little dripping. So the more you crank on it to seat the metal, it creates a seal and stop the flow. Well, it's almost the same principle here. It's lack of plenum and too much spring washers trying to keep it open. When it's shut, but not enough force behind it to apply enough pressure to really seal it. Now, each regulator stack, the spring tolerance and everything could vary. So if you're in that one particular rake pressure or stack on your spring, it creates some kind of leak. So it's better to adjust the stack, or the regular pressure might be higher to force it, to increase the mating force to shut it. Now, every gun is different. That's why you gotta find, well, 130 bars, it creeps. Well, once you try 110 bars or 150 bars and find out where it creates a better seal, right? So I don't know if I'm explaining that right, but it's all about how much pressure these two meet together. It's controlled by the plenum pressure and your spring washer. So there's a balance act between those two to have the proper pressure to keep them this piston and adjustment screw shut, and shut the supply to prevent creep. All right, let me explain it again in experience terms. You know, I've done the same procedure how I described how to polish the two surface. There's so many of them, I fixed the leak. I mean, totally gone. A lot of them, no more than a handful. I mean, there's so many of them I fixed that way, just by doing this process. Now, I've done it enough to say it's a very reliable process to minimize creep. If the other variable doesn't exist, this highly percentage rate, this will fix your creep issue. All right, so I'll make another part two video on this, and yeah, we'll see you next video. If you have any comments or explain something in detail. Well, I kind of went overboard, kind of a long video now, but drop me a line or a note to say, can you explain this or make a video of this? You know, even the M3 regulator is the same way. I mean, the newer one doesn't have this second, the second O-ring here. They're same piece, same piston. And you can do the same if you have an issue. But if you do this, I mean, polishing both ends, you may have to do it again. It's like a maintenance. Because, I don't know, you know, think of it as really high pressure. It's, or a river, Colorado River, going through this canyon. It eats away the canyon, makes it wider. Well, the same principle here. When it's almost shut, this pressure wants to come out. Even if so, if it's shut, this is the force pushing a piston open and wants to come out, right? And whatever you had there before, the micro fucking, scratches or gouges or imperfection, those things are going to get bigger, just a matter of time. Because there's a lot of pressure there. Once you escape, it is going to create a path. So, you know, it could be thousands of rounds of experiencing creep. I guarantee you, you need to do this process. All right? We'll catch you next video.